Hey everyone, welcome back to another video on DBT. In this video, we'll take a look at creating a custom schema and the changes you need to make in your project in order to make that happen. So custom schemas, why would you need to do that? By default, everything that we deploy here with no changes is going to deploy to our target schema that we've put in our profiles, which right now is public. And if we look back in Snowflake, everything is in public right now. And that works, but it's generally considered a best practice not to use public and to instead use some sort of custom schema that makes a little bit more sense. And there's all sorts of documentation in terms of how you might want to go about structuring your project. And in this example, we will look to create a schema called staging, which generally is considered the name of, you know, that first layer that sits just on top of the raw data sources. If we hop back into Visual Studio, there's two ways you can do this. The first is you could actually go into your specific model and use this config function here. In this case, this is going to override anything that you have set in your project. So for example, here, it's saying this particular model should materialize as a table, even though here we're saying, you know, do everything as a view. This will override it. So you could theoretically say schema, equals, you know, staging, if you wanted to. We're not going to do that here. Instead, what we will do is set it at the project level. I think this is much easier, and it allows you to match the way you create your DBT project with what actually shows up in Snowflake. So for example, let's say we wanted everything under this example folder to deploy to a custom schema called staging. The way we would do that is under here, just under materialized, add a plus, and then schema. The plus is new from some recent updates to DBT. I think you could actually do this here too if you wanted. And we will say staging. One thing to note as well is if you don't have the schema already built, DBT will create it for you. Just like it will create tables and views as it deploys, it will create the schema as well. Now, just looking at this, we would assume that this is going to just deploy to a new schema called just staging. And if we run this, we will actually notice it does something a little bit different. You can see here, start table model, it's deploying to public underscore staging. Why is that? Why isn't it just going to staging? And then if we go back into here, that's not a typo. It made a new schema called public staging and deployed those models. So why didn't it just go to just straight up staging? And the reason is the default setting in DBT is actually target schema underscore custom schema. It's going to concatenate it. So in our case, it's taking this public and concatenating it with this. So really it looks like, you know, public underscore staging. It's taking this and concatenating it here. But we don't want that. How do we get rid of that? And the way to do that is actually to update a macro that is built in to DBT. And this is one of the cool things about open source projects. You're able to actually adjust anything that comes with it. And they actually suggest it. Now, if you're following along, this will be our first example of a macro. And the way that we can use this is just to copy this code and create it on our project, and it will override it. So instead of using the default setting, it will recognize that we have this macro as well and use the code that we wrote. Under our macros folder here, let's create a new file. The name of the file isn't as important as the name of the macro, but it's best practice generally to match the name. It's just a little easier to work with. So we'll call this generate schema name.sql. Copy this in here, or paste this in here. And really what's important is this. This is what it's looking for, this particular macro. And right now we can see this is where that logic is happening with the underscore. So if we take this out, all it's going to do is say, if there is no custom schema, it's going to give it the default, but otherwise use the custom one. But now we've removed the underscore and this should work the way we expect it to. So it will see we have a custom schema run this logic and just give the name of that schema. So let's try again. And here we go, it worked. We can see it's just staging.modelName. There's no public underscore. And if we go into our project, or into our Snowflake environment, reset, we now have a staging schema with these models. And we can just drop schema public staging. Let's get rid of that one. And here we go. So now, everything in here, anything under example, will deploy to staging. But like I said, it's also generally best practice to match the name of the folder with your environment. So why don't we change this as well? Let's rename this. Oops. Let's rename this to staging. For it didn't exactly matter, but this will matter as well. We want this. This needs to align with the names. So if we wanted to keep the notes here. Now this is going to recognize models staging. And we're saying schema staging. So now our data warehouse environment aligns with our DBT project, and we can continue to build this out in the way that we want. Now I hope you found this helpful. Now you understand a little bit of how to create custom schemas using DBT and the slight changes you need to make to your project. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you at the next video.